The research that I do involves mood disorders, which is clinical depression or bipolar disorder. The bulk of the patients that I treat, they usually have mood disorders. Many of these patients also have concurrent anxiety issues and substance abuse problems. I mean, come very frequently as co-occurring disorders if you have a mood disorder. We use tools from neuroimaging, brain imaging, to study the brains of living patients and, you know, begin to understand the functional, neurochemical, and even anatomical abnormalities that they have compared to individuals who are mentally healthy. We have a very exciting new research. It's essentially implanting a device in the brain, in the brains of patients with treatment-resistant depression. The device is available and approved by the FDA for Parkinson's disease that does not respond to treatment. However, for depression, it is experimental, and it's a different part of the brain that we are targeting. The study we're doing is targeting what's called the medial forebrain bundle, which is a part of the brain really surrounded by key fiber pathways and tracts that interconnect these portions of the brain that are very much involved in regulating our emotions. Our colleagues did a small proof of concept study showing some very promising results.